My name is Josh.
I'm Armand Devania.
I'm Michael.
Thomas.
And together, four of us made an app called Vaporwave ARcade. Our final project was created with Augmented Reality, and it features three games. The three games, as well as the hub that connects them, are tied together with a Vaporwave aesthetic. For the uninitiated, Vaporwave is a niche genre of electronic music and meme culture that emerged on the internet within the last decade. Due to the nature of augmented reality, our project is best experienced from a mobile device. For this presentation, we have prepared a few videos that capture the experience of what it's like to use our app. If you're interested in trying the games out for yourself, we're happy to demo them as soon as the presentation is complete.
So when you first launch the app, it has the intro screen, and then you go into the menu. You're immediately put into augmented reality. As you can see, there's various screens that you can be able to click on in the different games. There's some nice music as well. So the first game we're going to play is Donut Drop, and the goal of this game is to catch donuts in a cup as they fall. And you initially have to find a plane similar to the previous AR app. And then once you select the plane, the game will begin. Each donut is worth 1 point. You try to get as many points as you can before time runs out. You play by moving the phone around in space to try and get it under the donuts as they fall. The original name for this was actually, the idea was the spears with balls bouncing towards you if you try to capture them. But we learned that this was pretty difficult because perception is pretty hard, just like a single point of view, and especially when you don't have context clues like high-quality lighting and shadows. So we created the donuts to be a set distance away, and you just have to try and get under them. So you just really have to spin in place. And then we wanted to give it a nice aesthetic, so instead of spheres, we made it a 90s jazz cup and donuts, because who doesn't like donuts?
To the second game, Heartbreaker. So this one is produced by Ford, which is using this zapper to shoot as much as the heart you can, and then try to avoid it. And then this game is kind of different from a traditional FPS game because we use the AR tech, so you have to really aim in the zapper towards the heart using your phone, like you're playing Pokemon Go. So it's definitely harder than you do. So I try to avoid the bomb and try to shoot the heart at the same time. And the smaller heart gives me more point. And yeah, the bomb will give you minus points. So yeah, get home with it, I guess. So this is a leaderboard. We can type our name and F and see if we got it. Yeah, I got it. First win.
First win.
Yeah, that's it, I guess.
Cool.
So this is our next game. It's called Kitty Pool. Let me show the video. So this is a whack-a-mole type game, except with moles, they're cats. And instead of whacking them, you are saving them from drowning. So the cats will appear randomly in the pool, and you have to be very quick to anticipate. And when you tap the cat, it disappears, and your score increases. The background, we have a sunset, and we have water as well as a bowl of gifts. This was our most resource-intensive game, so we really had to downsize some of the pictures and some of the objects just to make sure that it didn't crash because they were really big files. And yeah, that's it. And then I'll talk about the leaderboard for a bit. So these are our leaderboards. This is our all leaderboard menu. We use something called Firebase to hold all of our data. And it stores it in real time, meaning the moment that you update it, it will show up on your screen. and we're going to talk about technologies next.
So just real quick, to create this, for the guests, basically we use React Viro, React Native, and Firebase. So React Native, we learned JavaScript here. React Native lets us just easily make a mobile app using JavaScript. React Viro let us easily make augmented reality on top of that. And then Firebase allowed us to easily store our leaderboards online in a live place. And for the people that are students here, you already know what those are, so I'll explain them. And that's all.